Hi students, in the last class I discussed work energy theorem. In today's class we are going to see how this work energy theorem is applied in applications. Okay, so work energy theorem, how this theorem is applied. What is its statement? Net work done is equal to change in its kinetic energy. What is the simple statement? Statement is very simple. What is that? Net work done is equal to change in its kinetic energy. Okay, this is net work done. This is the simple statement. Change in kinetic energy. That is final kinetic energy K2 minus initial kinetic energy K1. So this theorem is very useful to us in solving the problems. How we can apply this theorem and how we can apply this theorem, let us see. Okay, in problems, first you decide the on which body you are going to apply this work energy theorem. This is the first step. You have to identify the body on which this work energy theorem is going to you are applying. Okay, first you identify the body, and the next you identify the initial and final positions. Okay, initial position, there you find kinetic energy K1, and final position, there kinetic energy, let it be K2. Okay, so these kinetic energies, whether you know or you don't know, that is these kinetic energies, whether they are known quantities or unknown quantities. So just you write the kinetic energies expressions, initial and final. Initial you assumed it as 1, final you assumed it as 2. So then the next case, in the body between 1 and 2, the positions 1 and 2, intermediate positions, you choose any position and you identify the forces acting on the body. Okay, and net, you find net work done done by the all the forces acting on the body, whether it is due to inertial frame of reference, in the inertial frame of reference. So you find work done by the all the forces acting on the body. Okay, then you summate all these work done, you will get a total work done. Okay, that net work done you equated to change in its kinetic energy. So this work done is equal to change in its kinetic energy. So this is statement is called work energy theorem. Let us see how we are going to apply this work energy theorem in applications. Okay, let us take this first example. Okay, so let us choose this example. A 5 kg ball applications, how we can apply this one. Okay, example 1, a 5 kg ball when falls through a height 20 meters, acquires a speed a speed of 10 meter second inverse. Find work done by the air resistance. So this is the problem. Okay, how we can solve this problem? Okay, let us see. A 5 kg ball when falls through a height 20 meters, it acquires a speed 10 meters second inverse. So you try to understand what is given. So a ball, when it falls through height 20 meters, its falls means initial velocity is zero. So it is a freely falling body. So initial velocity is zero. When it falls through a height, how much this height? 20 meters. It acquires a speed. How much here? This is, you assume this height is 20 meters, it acquires a speed v. How much it is? 20 meter second inverse. So you find this is the initial position where the velocity is zero, freely falling, and after traveling 20 meters, it acquires the speed 20 meter second inverse. So it acquires some kinetic energy. Here the kinetic energy is zero. The first one is, you identify the body on which work energy theorem is going to apply. So here this is the position 1 and position 2. Between these two positions we are applying work energy theorem. Here the velocity is zero, here velocity is 20 meters per second. So, and you find mass of the body, solution, mass of the body is 5 kg. So what is initial velocity? Initial velocity is zero. Then what is initial kinetic energy? K1 is equal to half m u square, that is zero. What is K2? After kinetic energy acquires half m v square, that is half m, m is 5, v square 20 square. So it acquires 20, velocity 20 into 20, let it be 10. So you will get 200 into 5, 1000. Okay, kinetic energy units is joules. Okay, so kinetic energy units is 2 into 5, 100 into 10, 1000 joules. That is final kinetic energy. Now in between intermediate state, you find the forces, work done by the all the forces. When you drop this one, which force, what are the forces acting on the object? So the gravitational force acts on that body. Because of gravitational force, it is falling down. The first one is gravitational force acting on it, and the second one is air resistance. Air opposes its motion, so that force will be acts in this direction. So there will be some air resistance will also opposes this motion. So you find work done by this all the forces. First you identify the what are the forces acting on the object. Okay, the first force is gravitational force. How much work is done by that mg, gravitational force is mg and displacement is h. It is positive work done by the gravitational force. So the forces acting on the object are, so the identify the forces, forces acting on it, on it are, for number one, gravitational force. Second one, air resistance. So these are the two forces act. Air opposes the motion of the object. We want work done by the air resistance. Okay, so this work done by the gravity, work done by the gravitational forces, it is mgh. So it is doing positive work. So that is m is 5, g let it be 10, h let it be 20 meters. Okay, this is 5 into 2000, it is 1000. Positive work done by the gravity is 1000. Okay, work done by the gravity, you take it as 9.8 gravitational force, that is not given. So it is how much? It is 2 into 9.8. How much it is? 5 into 2 into 5, 10. It is, I think, 980. 980 joules, work done by the gravitational force. So we want work done by the air resistance. We don't know, let it be air resistance. Resistive force, let it be R. You can assume A or R. So this is work done by the air resistance. We don't know, let it be, it is unknown, let it be X. Okay? So this is a question mark. Now you apply work energy theorem. So apply work energy theorem. So what you will get? What is work energy theorem? Net work done is equal to change in its kinetic energy, K2 minus K1. Okay? What is net work done? Work done by the gravitational force plus work done by the air resistance is equal to change in its kinetic energy. So final kinetic energy is 1000, initial kinetic energy is 0. So this is work done by the gravitational force is 980 plus work done by the air resistance. So we want this, so that is 1000. So work done by the air resistance is, it is 980 minus 1000, it is 20 joules. So work done by this air resistance is 20 joules. Okay? So here is M is 5, G is 10 into, you will get nearly 1000. So that's why we have taken G is 9.8. Okay? So then work done by the air resistance is 20 joules. Clear? So this is the solution for this problem. Okay? Half mv square. Here velocity acquired is how much? It is, sorry, here it is 10 meter second inverse. Here the speed acquired is 10 meter second inverse. We have taken 20, so you take it as 10. So here it is given value is 10, so you get it is 5. So 5 into 5, 25, 250 joules. Okay? So it is 250 joules. So here the speed is given as 10. So here kinetic energy acquires as half mv square. Half m is 5, v square is 10 into 10. So 2, 5 times gone, 5 into 5, 25 into 250. So the forces, this step is same, 980. So what you will get? Work done by this, here it is, work done by the gravitational force is 250. So it is 250. That is, here final kinetic energy minus initial kinetic energy. So 1000 minus 250. So how much you get? It is work done by the gravitational force is, it is 980. So here final kinetic energy is 250. So it is 250. Okay? So 250 minus 980. So 980 minus 250. How much? It is 0, 3, 8 minus 5, 3, and 9 minus 2, 7. 730. So it is minus 730 joules. What is the meaning of this minus? Because work done by this air resistance is negative. That means the force acting on the object is opposite to the displacement. Body displaces in this direction. Air resistance acts opposite to its motion. So here work done by air resistance is negative. Okay, we keep this one. Next problem. Okay. Suppose you take this one. You take second example. Example 2. Suppose a ball is dropped from a height h. A ball is dropped from a height h. From a height h on a sand floor. It penetrates into the sand through a distance s, and comes to rest. Okay, so come to rest. Find work done by the resistance force. Okay, so this is the problem. Okay, a ball of mass m, we assume mass of the ball is m. A ball of mass m, okay, is dropped from a height h on a sand floor. So the ball is dropped, initial velocity 0, and it is dropped from a height h, okay, and on a sand floor. This is the sand. So the ball penetrates into the sand through a distance, yes, and finally comes to rest. Okay, so this is the position. So you first identify on which work energy theorem is going to apply. So this is position 1, this is the position 2, where the velocity is 0. Here the velocity is 0. So first you identify the positions where the kinetic energies, where the position 1 and 2, initial position and final positions. So the ball is dropped from a height h. So this is the initial position. So here the sand starts and it penetrates into the sand. So when it penetrates into the sand, the sand opposes its motion. Its resistance force, let it be F. Find the resistance force. So we have to find the resistance force. I want, not work done. Okay, so I want this resistance force. So apply work energy theorem. So first you identify the positions 1 and 2. So solution. So position 1, initial velocity 0, where kinetic energy is, what is kinetic energy? Initial kinetic energy is 0, final velocity will be 0, so final kinetic energy will be 0. So I identified the positions 1 and 2. Then in between this, what are the forces acting on it? So the gravitational force acts downwards, gravity acts downwards, and the resistance force acts upwards. So there are two forces acting on that. So you identify the forces and work done by the forces. So work done by the forces. First identify the forces. What are the forces? Number one is gravitational force. So gravitational force. So what is work done by the gravitational force? Gravitational force is mg, and from here to here gravitational force is mg only. So displacement is h plus s. So it is done by the positive work, H plus S. That is the total displacement because of the gravitational force. Once the ball, it penetrates into the sand after falling from certain height, because at the time of falling it has kinetic energy. With the help of that energy, it will penetrate into the sand and travels, it retards and travels certain distance and finally comes to rest. So the total distance traveled by the ball is H plus S. So what is work done by this gravitational force? Force into displacement. Force is, gravitational force is mg, total displacement is H plus S. So this is work done is positive, because gravitational force is acting down, displacement is down. So this is this work done is positive work done. Second one is resistance force offered by the sand, resistance force. So work done by this resistance force, R is, this is gravitational force, work done by the force into displacement. So here, from here the sand starts acting this force. This resistance force offered by the sand starts from here, here to here. So the displacement is here to here is S only. But force is like this, displacement is like this. So it is negative work done by this force. So F is minus F into S. This minus indicates it is work done by the resistance force is negative. I want this. So I am applying work energy theorem. Apply work energy theorem, WH theorem. What it says, that net work done by the gravity plus work done by the resistance force is equal to change in its kinetic energy, K2 minus K1. Okay? That is, K2 minus K1. K2 is 0, K1 is 0. Work done by gravity is mg of H plus S minus F into S. Okay? Is equal to 0. I want F. F is equal to mg of H plus S by S. So that is, resistance force is mg of 1 plus H by S. Okay? This is the answer for this question. Okay? H by S. Okay? So how much force is offered by this sand to the ball? Mg of 1 plus H by S. Clear? This is also one of the applications of, we are applying here work energy theorem. You take another example. So we are discussing applications of work energy theorem. Okay? You take another example. A box of mass, third example. Example 3. A box of mass 10 kg is projected up. Is projected up an inclined plane, up an inclined plane, inclined plane, inclined plane, from the foot, foot, with a speed of, with a speed of 20 meter second inverse, as shown in the figure, is as shown in figure. Okay, I will draw the diagram. Coefficient of friction between the box and the plane is 0.5. So it is represented with the letter mu, 0.5. Okay. Find the distance traveled by the box on the plane before it stops first time. Find distance traveled by the box. Distance traveled by the box before on the plane before it stops first time. Okay. So that is the problem. So here the diagram is given. So this is the inclined plane of 37 degrees. So angle of inclination is given as 37 degrees. A box is projected up along the plane with the velocity 20 meter second inverse. So let it be a box of mass m. Okay. Now it is projected along the plane. How much distance it travel before coming to rest? Okay. So this is the problem. So you are projected a body along the plane. So what happens? So it will travels along the plane against gravity. So it is retarded. So its velocity and the friction is also there. So gravitational force and friction both are acting downwards. As the object is moving forward, frictional force is back because it opposes the relative motion. We are assumed that this wedge is fixed. Now friction opposes, gravity is also opposes. So there are two forces acting on the object. What are the forces acting on the object? Gravitational force and frictional force. These are the two forces. So the body is retarded, and after traveling certain distance, its velocity of the body becomes zero. So you take this position is 2. I take this position is 1. So I identify the between these two, it travels a distance s. I want this s, distance traveled by this. Okay. I want this S. Okay, distance traveled. I want S. So how do you calculate this? So use work energy theorem. Okay, so first you identify the positions 1 and 2. Yes, I identified solution. So what is initial kinetic energy? K1 is equal to half m v1 square. Okay, half m v square. So what is initial kinetic energy? Half. What is m? Mass of the box is 10 kg into v square. It is projected with velocity 20 meter second inverse. So 20 into 20. So 2, 10. So this is 2, 1, 2, 3. So 2000 joules. Okay. So that is the initial kinetic energy. Final kinetic energy. So it travels certain distance and finally comes to rest. So their kinetic energy is zero because velocity is zero. So kinetic energy is velocity zero. So kinetic energy is zero. Between 1 and 2, what are the forces acting on that? Gravitational force and frictional force. You find the work done by these forces. Okay. I'm going to calculate work done by the forces. So work done by the forces. What are the forces? Number one is gravitational force. So gravitational force. How much gravitational force? Work done by the gravitational force. When the object is here, the gravitational force acts downwards. So I will write here. When the object is here, intermediate state. So what are the positions here? Mg sin theta acting down, and a normal reaction, and Mg cos theta. It is balanced with the Mg cos theta. Work done by these two forces is zero. Why? Because displacement is in this direction, normal reaction is acts normal to the displacement. So here theta is 90, hence work done by these two forces N and Mg cos theta is zero. But this Mg sin theta, we want work done by this Mg sin theta. So Mg sin theta is a component of gravitational force along the down the plane. So work done by it, body displaces in this direction. So its work done is force into displacement. Mg sin theta into displacement, let it be S. Since the force is down, displacement is up, it is negative work done. So this work done by the gravitational force is negative, that is force is Mg sin theta into S. This is work done by the gravitational force. That is, okay, what is Mg? M is 10, G let it be 10, sin 37, sin 37 into S. S is unknown. So how much it is? It is sin 37 is how much? Sin 37 is 3 by 5. So 5, 2 times. So 2 into 3, 6. 6 into 10, 60. So this is 60 S. Okay? So this is a negative. And work done by the frictional force. Frictional force is also negative. So how much it is? Minus frictional force. Frictional force into displacement. What is the frictional force? Mu n minus mu n into S. So minus mu n is n balances with the Mg cos theta. So I will write Mg cos theta into S. Now you substitute the values. Mu is 0.5. M is 10, G let it be 10, cos 37 into S. What is cos 37? Cos 37 is 4 by 5. So this 5, you will get 0.1 times. 0.1 into 10, 1, 10. So 10 into 4, 40S. So that is minus 40S. What is this minus indicates? Work done by the friction is also negative. So total work done. So I am applying work energy theorem. Okay. So the next step is, I will write here. Find distance traveled by the box on the plane before it stops the first time. So I want a distance traveled. Okay. I am using this space. So I am rubbing this one. Okay, so apply this work energy theorem. So apply work energy theorem. So what is that? Work done by net work done is work done by the gravity plus work done by the friction is equal to change in its kinetic energy. Final kinetic energy minus initial kinetic energy. Okay. So work done by the gravity is minus 60S, work done by the friction is minus 40S, we want S, kinetic energy, final kinetic energy 0, initial kinetic energy 2000, okay. So this is minus minus get cancelled, 60 plus 40, 100S is equal to 2000. minus minus get cancelled. So S is equal to 2000 by 100, 20 meters. So what is the answer here? 20 meters. Okay. So this box, if you project with velocity 20 meters second inverse, it travels how much distance? 20 meters before coming to rest, before it stops. Clear? So I solved this problem by using work energy theorem. Clear? You take another example. Suppose there is a spring of force constant K. Okay, a block M is attached to it. So it has its natural length. Now it elongates through a distance x. Suppose you are applying a force F. You are pushing a block of mass M is suspended from a spring of force constant K. Okay, now it is held to keep the spring in relaxed state as shown in the figure. So the first state is it is held at rest. It is held to keep the spring. It is held to keep the spring to keep the spring it is held to keep the spring in its relaxed length in its relaxed length okay as shown in the figure, as shown, okay. So, a box, body M is held to keep the spring in its relaxed length as shown, okay. Now, the applied force is decreased gradually so that the block moves downwards at negligible speed. How far below the initial position will the block will stop? So case one. So it is applied force decreases gradually. Now it is released slowly. First one is body is released slowly with negligible speed in the first case, and second case body is released suddenly. Body is released suddenly. Then in both cases find extension in the spring in both cases. Okay. So this is the problem. Okay? Now see, listen. Here, there is a spring of spring constant K. A body of mass M is attached to other end. One end is attached to the roof. It is fixed. Other end, a block of mass M is attached. And it is held. That means keep your hand like this. And the spring has its natural length. Okay? Now, the body is released slowly with a negligible speed in the first case. Okay? When it releases slowly, so with a negligible speed, how long it is moving down until it, suppose it extends through a distance x naught, elongates. So as it elongates, the spring force acts in this direction. So that spring force acts in this direction, it opposes. So gravitational forces acts downwards. So in case 1, we draw FBD. What is FBD? FBD of KX balances with MG. This is M. So MG. So under equilibrium, since it is moving slowly, these two forces will always balance. At certain instant, this MG balances as you are releasing this one, this block slowly with a negligible speed, slowly as you are moving down with a decreasing force, as it decreasing, this spring force increases. And at certain instant, these two will balance. Then you can release your hand. So these two forces releases, so balance. So Kx is equal to Mg. Under equilibrium, these two forces will balance. So Kx is equal to Mg. So we want x. So x naught is equal to Mg by K. Okay? So that is Mg by K. So you call it as equation 1. X naught is equal to Mg by K. And case 2, okay, body is released suddenly from relaxed position, then find extension in the spring. So in the second case, if you release it, case 2, if you release it suddenly, what happens is suddenly, if you release it suddenly from this position, so the spring elongates. So suddenly, how much it elongates? Now we want, we don't know how much it elongates, let it be x. So this is the position where you are releasing. Here the velocity is 0. Before you are releasing, so you are held this block in case 2. Before releasing, you held this block. Suddenly you release the force. What happens? Suddenly it will fall. Why? Because of gravitational force. As it falls down, here the two forces, this is the position 1. At the time of release, its velocity is 0. As it elongates more and more, it is, since it is connected to the spring force gradually increases. So at certain instant, what happens? Finally it will comes to rest. So how much it elongates, we don't know, let it be x. So if I want to apply work energy theorem here, okay, first you identify the position 1 and position 2. So case 2, I identify the position 1 and 2. At position 1, before releasing, velocity is 0. So at the maximum extension, its velocity is again 0. So their kinetic energies are 0. So in case 2, initial velocity is 0 and K1 is 0, final velocity is 0,
and K2 is 0. So we have, since velocities are 0 at positions 1 and 2, their kinetic energies are 0. Now, what are the forces acting on this spring? So here there are two forces, gravitational force acting downwards and spring force acting upwards. So there are two forces acting on the spring. You find the work done by these two forces. Okay? So work done, the next step is work done by the forces. What are the forces? Number one is gravitational force. Gravitational force. Gravitational force is mg into x. So that is positive work, mgx, positive work done by the gravity, mgx, where x is the extension. Okay. Number two is work done by spring force. Work done by spring force. Actually, it will be stored in the form of potential energy, but it is doing negative work, that is half kx square. So this work done by the spring force, it is stored in the form of potential energy, but it has doing negative work. So that is minus half kx square. This is work done by the spring force. So now you apply work energy theorem. Okay, I will write here, apply work energy theorem. Work energy theorem. What is work energy theorem? Work done by gravity plus work done by the spring force is equal to change in its kinetic energy, K2 minus K1. Okay? And work done by gravity is mgx. Work done by the spring force is minus half kx square. Is equal to final kinetic energy, initial kinetic energy, 0 minus 0, 0. So what you will get? I want x. So half kx square is equal to, I will write here. Okay? I will rub this diagram. I need this space. Case 1, I rub. So mgx is equal to half kx square. So I want x. So 1x get cancelled, x is equal to 2mg/k. So what is the answer? So if you release the spring suddenly, how it will elongates? mg/k. Okay? So this is the answer. So to solve this problem, here I am using work energy theorem. So if you held this block, once again I am repeating. So conclusion, what is that? If you, this block is removed slowly, then it elongates, x0 is equal to mg/k. But if you release it suddenly, then it elongates how much? 2mg/k. So this is the answer. Do you understand? Take this. So we are discussing applications of work energy theorem. Okay. Next problem. A block of mass .5 kg slides from a point A. On a horizontal track, okay, with initial speed v is equal to 3 m/s². Okay. Towards a horizontal spring. Horizontal spring. of length 1 meter, force constant length 1 meter and K force constant 2 Newton meter inverse. The part AB of the track is frictionless. AB is a frictionless, and the part BD has friction mu, coefficient of static and kinetic frictions, static and kinetic frictions 0.22 and 0.22 respectively. Okay, if the distance AB and BC, the distances AB is equal to AB and BC are 2 meters and 2.14 meters respectively, the total distance through which the block moves before it comes to rest. Total distance. Total distance through which the block moves. Through which the block moves. Block moves. Before it comes to rest completely. Before it comes to rest completely. G, you take it as 10. Okay. So, it comes to rest before it comes to rest completely. So, this is the problem. The given diagram is, so the block will be like this, spring will be like this. One end of the spring is connected like this, and there is A, this is the point A, this is the point B, AB, and C. Here the spring will start, okay, and it has natural length. This spring has natural length. It has K value, K. So K is given as 2 Newton meter inverse. Okay. This is a spring. One end is fixed. Okay. And this is connected to this point C. Okay. B. And A. Okay. So, we want this distance is given. So, this is AB is a frictionless. That distance is how much? It is AB part is 2 meters. So, until 2 meters there will be no friction. From B to C it is a friction. So, and when this block moves with the same speed up to B, so it has same kinetic energy because there is no friction since it is smooth. From here to here there is friction and it will hit the spring. okay, and the spring compresses through a distance, and the block, as the spring compresses, spring force acts in this direction. Now it will retard, okay, the block maybe comes to rest. So you first, you find the here at B, kinetic energy is, you identify the positions where the work energy theorem is you are going to apply. So I am going to apply this distance AB between the points AB and CD. So I assumed that after traveling a distance from here, so let it be X. This is the maximum compression of the spring. Let it be, okay. And the block will ultimately comes to rest. So this distance is BC. This distance is how much? It is BC is given as 2.14 meters. 2.14 meters plus XM. It has friction. So solution. We want a total distance traveled by this block before coming to rest. Okay, see the solution. First you find initial position where the velocity is. So initial velocity is, velocity of the block is 3 meter second inverse. So mass of the block is 0.5 kg. So what is its kinetic energy? K1 is equal to half m v square. So that is half m. Mass of the block is 5, v square, 3 into 3, 9. So this is 2 into 9 by 2, 4.5. 4.5 into 0.5. How much? That is the initial kinetic energy. Okay. So what is initial kinetic energy? It is nearly 4 into 0.5, 2.5. So this is 2.25, 45 into 5, 225, isn't it? 45 into 5. So you will get 5 5s are 25, 20, 25. So 2.25, okay, 2.25 joules. So here is initial kinetic energy. When it comes to rest, final kinetic energy becomes 0. So final kinetic energy becomes 0. So between these two positions, here is also kinetic energy half mv square. Same kinetic energy it will possess. Here A and B, kinetic energy is same. So work done by these forces between B and D. So here work done by these forces will be here B and C, between B and C. So work done by the forces. First you find the forces, work done by the forces. So first you identify the forces. Number one is, what are the forces acting on it? Here it is from B to C, frictional force. The number one is frictional force. Frictional force, work done by the frictional force, that is work done by the frictional force is F into S minus, that is F mu into N, mg mu N, N means mg into S. S means total distance. B to C, that is 2.4 plus X. X is the compression in the spring, okay. So what is X here? Compression in the spring, let it be X. So how much it is? Mu is, it is coefficient of kinetic friction. When it is motion, it is 0.2. So it is 0.2. So it is minus. Work done by the friction is minus. M is, it is 0.5 into G, let it be 10. S 2.14 plus x. So that is 2 into 10 point 2, 2 into 5, 10, 1. So that is minus 2.14 plus x. So this is net work done by the frictional force. Okay. What are the second forces acting on it? That is spring force. So how much work done by this spring force? You calculate. So I will write here. Okay, I will take this space. So what is work done by this first force is frictional force, another force is spring force. Number two, spring force. What is work done by the spring force is k. Work done by the spring force is minus half k x square. As I told, it will be stored in the form of potential energy, that is minus half k is 2 into x square. 2 to get cancelled, minus x square. This is work done by the spring force. As it is, spring compresses in this direction, force will act in this direction. So this work done by the spring force is displacement will be in this direction, it is negative. So So x square. So I want the next one is here. Next, apply work energy theorem. Apply work energy theorem. WEH, work energy theorem. What is work done by the frictional force? What it says? Net work done is equal to change in its kinetic energy. So work done by the frictional forces plus work done by the spring force is equal to change in its kinetic energy, k2 minus k1. So work done by the spring force is how much? Minus 2.14 plus x minus half x square, that is minus x square into k2. What is k2? Here k2 is 0. What is K1? K1 is 2.25. So this minus will get cancelled here. So you will get x square. I will take x square plus x. Here you will get minus will get cancelled. Here you will get minus also get cancelled. You bring this one this side. So what you will get? It will become 2.214 minus 2.25. How much it is? 2.25 minus 2.14. You bring this side, it will become minus. So that is 1 1 0. So 0.11, 5 minus 4 1 1 1. So minus 0.11 is equal to 0. You simplify this, you will get x. Okay, so what we got the quadratic equation. How much it is? 2.x square plus x plus 2.14 is equal to 2.25. So you solve this quadratic equation, you will get I think you know the how to solve the quadratic equation. Okay, you solve this one, solve, we get x you will get as 0.1 meters, x as 0.1 meters, you will get this one. Okay, so I think you know how to solve this one. So here, once it compresses, we want a total distance traveled by the block. Okay, once this spring compresses completely, at the extreme position
you draw this FBD, this block M, here the spring force will act in this direction. So the spring force and frictional force will act. Spring force will push us like this, frictional force will act like this. So this is friction, kinetic, static friction. Frictional force, this is spring force. So you have to check whether these two forces are greater or not, spring force and frictional force, at the maximum extension. Spring force is minus kx, frictional force is mu s mg. So you check these two values. What is k? 2 into x is 0.1, that will become 0.2 newtons. Spring force, the spring force is 0.2 newtons, and static frictional force value is mu is 0.22 into m is how much? M is given as 0.5 into g, let it be 10. So how much it is? It is 0.22. You will get how much it is? 0.22 into 5. You will get 1.1 newtons. So this is static frictional force value. Once this block compresses the spring and it reaches to maximum extension, their frictional force, the block will momentarily comes to rest. Their static friction is 1.1 and the spring force, work done by the spring force is 0.2. So once after this, the block will be stopped there, because if the spring force is more, it will push us back, if this more than this static frictional force. So once it moves back or not, you have to check, because we want a total distance traveled by this block. So here what happens here, spring force is less than Fs, so the block will comes to rest only here. So I will write here, since so last step I will write here, what is that? Since so total distance traveled, we want a total distance traveled, how much traveled by the block, by the block before it comes to rest, before it stops. Okay, this 2 meters plus 2.1 meters plus x, there it will stops. So this is 2 into 2, x is 2 plus 2.14 plus x 0.1. So how much you got? 2.14 plus 2.1, how much? 4.54. So it will distance, say how much it will travels before coming to rest, total distance travel before it comes to rest, how much it is? It is 4.24. It is, this is 2. Okay, so this is 4.24 meters. So this is the answer. So total distance it traveled before coming to rest. Okay, whether it is moving back or not, you have to check here. Since frictional force, spring force is less than this static friction, it won't move further. Okay, you take this. So we discussed, these are the few applications of work energy theorem. By understanding these applications, you have to solve other problems. Okay, clear regarding this work energy theorem, how we apply it in applications. Okay. take this.